सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट एंड ग्रीन इकोनॉमी, सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट एंड ग्रीन इकोनॉमी। टुडे एवरीवन इज गेनिंग मनी, दैट इज इन एवरी पार्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड द इकोनॉमी इज इंक्रीजिंग। सो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट वी आर यूजिंग अप द रिसोर्सेस, नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस, रिसोर्सेस प्रोवाइडेड बाय अवर मदर अर्थ। सो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट द करंट स्ट्रेटजीज, करंट वे, करंट मेथड्स वी आर डूइंग इट, देयर विल बी सीरियस एनवायरमेंटल प्रॉब्लम्स एंड वी आर विटनेसिंग इट टूडे। वी आर फेसिंग ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ एनवायरमेंटल प्रॉब्लम्स टूडे। जस्ट थिंक वॉट विल हैपन टू अवर फ्यूचर जनरेशंस। पॉपुलेशन इज इंक्रीजिंग, इनकम इज ऑल्सो इंक्रीजिंग। सो पीपल वॉन्ट, पीपल हैव मनी नाउ, दे वॉन्ट गुड्स, दे वॉन्ट लग्जरी, they want everything that makes their life easy. Now, when they are needing it, when there is a demand, there will be a supply. So that supply will come from production. And when the production is done, manufacturing is done, there will be a utilization of, or say exploitation of, natural resources. This is how this works. So what we need to think about this? The society must change. The society as a whole must change the today unsustainable development strategy. We have to change it. That is those strategy, those methods, those techniques we are adopting, because it is going to destroy the environment. We need to have those kind of strategy for sustainable development that won't destroy our environment, our earth. And this can be brought only when you and me as individual live a good life, a sustainable lifestyle. We cannot just leave everything to the government. For example, if I don't litter, I just say people are littering. Let them litter. Don't throw any waste. You by yourself live a sustainable life. Switch off your fan, switch off your life when it is not required. This is what you can do in order to save energy, in order to save the world. So we have to have a judicious utilization of resources, because the non-renewable are scarce. They are nowhere, they are limited. And those we are saying that they will be coming in few years, they will take lakhs of years. So what is the definition of sustainable development? Sustainable development, it means, that is the definition given by World Commission of Environment and Development. In 1987, WCED, it gave a definition. Definition is the development that meets the needs of the present today without compromising the ability of future generation to meet their own needs. In simple words, what we are doing today, what we are eating today, what we are using today, we need to do it in a way so that these all things remain for our kids, for their kids, for their kids. We are talking about future generations. We have to save for them. We have to think about them, which we are not thinking today. For instance, sustainable agriculture, what does it mean? Sustainable agriculture means environment friendly methods. If you do farming, if you do agriculture, use the environment friendly methods. That is, either you are growing a crop or a livestock like the cattle, okay, cow, bullocks, anything. You have to do in such a way so that it is not damaging the human or natural system, like the food chain, like the ecology, like the biodiversity. Because we are using chemicals. And because we are using chemicals and over-utilizing the resources, it is going to adversely affect the soil, water, and biodiversity. I am again saying, we are using chemicals and they will ultimately be finding its way to our food chain, to water, to soil, even to our biodiversity, Jav Vividhata. It will come there. What will you do with this? You have to eat it without even knowing it. These are the adverse effect, detrimental effect of doing this. So now the words I just uttered is biodiversity. What is biological diversity? That is, in a part of nature, you get variety of plants and animal species. That is richness of all the plant and animal species in a region, country, even a world. If you're using chemical, basically you are drugging other people. You are slowly letting them die. So these plants and animal species have to be there. You need biodiversity. There is an ecosystem. We need it to be rich. We need to be natural. And I'm not just talking about the terrestrial. I'm talking about the terrestrial, that is the land, and aquatic, that is the water. We need biodiversity. We have to increase the biodiversity. Otherwise, all these species will be, they are already endangered and they are going to die, extinct. This is essential for preserving our ecological processes. For example, the nutrients. If you grow a crop, the nutrients of the soil will vanish. So this will add, this preserving of ecological process will fix the nutrients. Soil formation is a long process. The air and water, all this circulation, cleansing of air and water is done by this biodiversity. Global life support, that is, as I said, carbon dioxide will release and we get oxygen from the plants, trees. Water is there. We need to protect the water. We need to save the water. We have to keep the streams of water flowing throughout the year. We see that most of the perennial river, they have gone. They are now dry. So we need erosion control. We want to keep the land intact. And the flood, the famine, most of the things which are happening, we need to avoid them, stop them. So this is the picture of biodiversity. What does it mean? Humans, animals, birds, small organisms, big organisms, water, mountain, everything is living there in harmony. So what is sustainable development? What does it mean? Sustainable development is basically a long term. So the development that satisfies the need of today without even compromising the requirement or need of future generation. That is, you complete your need, but after 50 years, 100 years, 1000 years, we don't know human life goes up to what extent. But till the third time your generations are there, please guarantee them that they will get something. We have to balance between the immense economic growth, the strategies we are adopting, non-green strategy. So we need environmental and social well-being, not only for us, for everyone. So this word, sustainable development, or a concept you can say, this has first come in 1987. There was a report being published and that was called as Brundtland report. This woman you see is, you can say, the initiator. And in 1987, about knowing all the problems, they said, the report said, what is the negative or the bad consequences of on environment of the economic growth and the globalization which is going on at an exponential rate? Nobody is against economic growth or globalization, but we are against the wrong strategy, the strategies which are stopping the world life. Everyone today, 20 years, nobody took aircraft, but now in India, everyone is taking aircraft. So this report has started this world, a concept called as Sustainable Development, Brundtland Report in 1987. So what does it mean? What it includes? It has various aspects. First is, we need the resource conservation. That is, we are using it so excessively in such a rapid pace, we need to stop this, to do the conservation or stop this rate. Whatever waste material are there, try to reduce, recycle and reuse. All the scientific management should go in that direction in order to prosper the bioresources, the renewable resources. So this has to be very scientific. The management has to be there. Planting trees, this is the most important. One tree you cut, I say grow tree. You need to have green grassy patches, trees in between the concrete jungle. Stop using plastic. Always use anything which is biodegradable. Plastic will remain with you, with your kids and future generation for millions of years. It is not biodegradable. But the nature cannot break it into the substances which can be non-harmful. So use today's technology, which are environmental friendly. Today we have air conditioned 5-star, 6-star, they have energy rating. Use them. Narendra Modi ji is saying the principle of common but differentiated responsibilities is the bedrock of our enterprise, for a sustainable world. Everyone in the world should come together. Sustainable Development Goals, SDG. So this SDG, this is also called as Global Goals. What does it mean? The goal is basically what you think, lakshya, what is your ultimate path, what you want to achieve. So what are the goals of this sustainable development concept? We are also calling it as Global Goals. This is a call to the world. This is a universal call. First, you need to end the poverty. Most of the people in the world, they don't even get two time of food. We have to protect this planet, the Mother Earth. And we need everyone, rich, poor, everyone needs peace and prosperity. So this is the glimpse I'm trying to show you. These are all the global goals. So it was launched, this SDG were launched at United Nations Sustainable Development Summit, that is UNSDS, in New York in September 2015. And there was an agenda of 2030, that is 2030 agenda for the sustainable development. And this 17 Sustainable Development Goals, SDG, which you are witnessing here also, these are adopted by all the big world leaders in 2015. And there was a roadmap, there was embodying a roadmap for progress that is sustainable, that is long-lasting, long-term, thinking of future. And also in the same time, leaving no one behind, not a single one behind. Right? So first is, we need everyone to be at equal level. And second thing, we need progress in a sustainable manner. So this SDG are being made frame, and the basic objective was to address the vital issues. First is businesses. It is talking about a business. It is talking about government and the society. It's talking about removing or minimizing the poverty, gender equality, water use, energy use, climate change, and the biodiversity. So these all are the points which are framed, and the most of the countries, they have started making policies and regulation in order to promote this sustainable development or system. that in every economic sector, they're secure, they're affordable, and sustainable in economy. Let me give an example of a solar cooker. Solar cooker, if you want to use, you need people who are skilled. So you need green worker, people who know how to work with the green things. Green skills have to be developed. They need to know the environmental aspects. They need to be aware of the environment. And also they have the inner willingness, the inner belief for the sustainable development. Okay? They want to do it and they will do it. We have to develop that knowledge and skill also for everything to be green. Green growth. So what kind of development should be green? It can be called as the development where green or some aspect of environment is involved. So economic growth, what is the concept? This is achieving economic growth that is socially inclusive. Socially inclusive means everyone, poor or rich or mediocre. Along with this, it has to be environmentally sustainable also. Our ministry, that is the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India, it has recognized the green growth. And what it has recognized as green growth, what is the vision, what is the thought? So whether it is environment or a forest or even the climate change like global warming, etc. The vision is, first thing is poverty eradication. Still there is poverty. Most rich and most poor people live here only. But it has to have green growth. That is, for green economy, this green growth has to be the key point, keeping in mind the poverty eradication, but it has to be green. The Finance Commission of India, how they have commissioned it, they have thought it, or the articulation of this green growth, that is rethinking or again thinking or changing the growth strategies, the strategies, the techniques, the methods we are adopting, what it should be with regard to their impact on environment sustainability. That is, the economy should grow like this, that everyone, like the poor people, the vulnerable people, the groups which are poor or which are, say, not that much grown up in decades, centuries. So environmental resources also have to be seen. So basic thing is resources, how much resources we are using, how much resource we need. And because economic growth has to be there, because economic growth will not be there, economy will not be there, how people will get job, how will they earn their livelihood? It has to be there. So job creation has to be there, social equity has to be there, but it should be all economic growth has to be depending on the resources. So in order to ensure the sustainable development, what we can do? See, industries and manufacturing plants, this also has to be there. So this is important for economic development. But what will be its economic impacts, environmental impacts? That is, I'll give an example. Because everything which is has to be done by a country, it may be any country. Let us take an example of a car or your vehicle, your truck. Now you are always stuck in traffic. Now the pollution will grow multifold. You are wasting your time, or you are wasting others' time also, commuters also. And then the pollutant or the other gases, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, nitrous oxide, ozone depleting gases. So they are going to affect us in a detrimental way in coming future. I'm not saying don't go by car, but you cannot change it in one day. You have been using your car or bike for almost 10, 20 years now. But we need to develop a public this transport system, or the strategies or method, or the, you know, different kind of, not the conventional, different kind of transport system, which are economical viable. That is, they are green vehicles, not painted green, but they are, the environmental impact is as least as possible. Green economy. Economy is all about money. How money transact, or how this wheel of money runs in a country. But we are talking about green economy. What does it mean? First, when does this term coined? This term called green economy was coined in 1989. And this was in a report for the government of the United Kingdom. And who wrote this report? This was by a group of leading environmental economists. And they gave a blueprint or a framework for a green economy. So I am talking about those environmental economists, that is, those are environmentalists also, thinking about the nature and also about the country's economy. So this is the blueprint they created for the government of United Kingdom in 1989, and that is how this word has come. United Nations Environment Program, UNEP, they also defined this term or this concept. That is, one that results in improved human well-being and social equity. We need social equity. Everyone has to be equal. Along with this, reducing environmental risk and ecological scarcities. That is, the resources are limited. We need to use them wisely. And we have to see also that anything what we are doing, what environmental risk or impacts we are thinking about. For example, low carbon dioxide. We want low carbon. We don't want more carbon dioxide. See, the earth gets light from sun. So there is absorbed light which earth releases. Now, because of our layering of atmosphere, our earth remains warm. Otherwise, it would be like the poles, North Pole, South Pole, because sunlight never goes there or doesn't reach there. Otherwise, every part of the world will be like that only, right? So we have to use them judiciously, all these resources, and we need to involve people also. Okay, so we need social inclusivity also. This 2011 UNEP has said. So economy, a green economy is economic growth, but simultaneously, same time, we have to take care of the environment as well. So what are the different ways of economic growth? What are the thoughts, vision and techniques? Let us take an example. Factories, if you are building factories, or you can take an example of agriculture. Now we are using chemicals like fertilizers, insecticide, pesticide. We are using everything here because we want more production. People are so many, they want everything. So we have to produce for them. There is a demand, so need, supply has to begin. So fertilizers, why not to use the organic fertilizers, vermicompost, like this? Because everyone know now, almost, these fertilizers, insecticides and pesticides, eventually, they are in our food chain. They are affecting us. They are affecting flora. They are affecting fauna. They are affecting plants. They are affecting microorganisms. So this is a health hazard. Now, people should learn about this, or by the time they know about this, that this is the serious health impact or hazards of these pesticides, insecticides. So they will put pressure on these farmers that if you grow organically, then only we are going to use. Okay. So now these chemicals in slow phase, they will be discarded and the organic things can be used. As I'm saying, demand supply is already there. Because if you demand for organic, they'll give you organic. If you demand, if you are not demanding, people will produce with any chemical they want. They'll use anything for money. So you have to be a great, great green consumer. So who is a green consumer? Green consumer is that person who is quite concerned about the environment, like the plant, like the soil, pollution, everything. And only purchase those goods or products or services that are economically viable, environment friendly and eco-friendly. For example, take a product with minimum packaging. Take a product which has only the natural ingredients without any preservatives or chemicals. And whatever you are using doesn't cause pollution after using. Land pollution, water pollution, air pollution, it shouldn't cause. So these are very small things a person has to know, understand, so that he becomes a green consumer. Components of a green economy. So for a greener economy, that is an economy, it can be of world economy, it can be a state economy. So we have certain components related to this green economy. First is renewable energy, because everything is about energy. You need energy for everything. Even for your body, if you want to live, you need energy. So now you can use the renewable energy. Renewable energy will always remain there, like wind, water, sun, earth, the biomass. All these, the picture which you are witnessing is all about using the renewable energy. Like wind has energy, water has energy, sun is the almighty. And you know about this sun's energy. Earth has energy inside, like the geothermal energy. Biomass can be used, that is waste can be used to make energy. So these are available in abundance, large quantity. And they are not causing pollution also. And India, along with, there are so many countries, for the production of renewable energy, like solar, wind and biomass, we are on the top 10. Now you have to tell me, there is a country that uses this windmill. Most of the energy is coming from windmill. Now you need to tell me that. Green building. It's not about painting your building into green. Green building, these are the buildings, when they are made, they cause minimum damage or any kind of detrimental effect to the environment while it is constructing, and once it is being constructed, while it is operating also. That is, the energy, water and the resources used here are used judiciously, wisely, in an eco-friendly manner. And also the waste being produced is as minimal as possible. It cannot be zero. It can never be zero. But it has to be minimum. That is why we call it as green building. Because one building, even if you, 10 to decrease all these by energy conservation for say 10%, and the waste, everything will change in the world. Now coming to the transport. Well-managed, sustainable transport. For example, you see, everyone now, we have, how many people are there in your house? Everyone will have a bike or a car. Means, we have to go, we have to take transport. So we have to, mostly people, they have their own transport. Now the problem is, it is affecting the environment. A sustainable transport system has to be developed, which has to be low cost, because everyone can afford it. And people can move from one place to another. For example, electric cars are there. And it causes less effect. For example, if you take a car, it goes only to 10 to 20 kilometer per charging. You will not be in a mood to take it. So it has to be, good also. And it must create minimum damage to the environment. Or no damage to the environment. Water management. Without water, without air, you cannot live. So water management is important, because avoiding or stopping water pollution, we don't want waste water. This is not only bad for us, but for different flora and fauna also. every drop is important. Okay, rather, you know, we should recycle it. Or if some water you have already used, you can use it for different purpose, like watering the plants, like you know, washing your car, which already you have used. Next thing is waste management. Normally what we do, we put everything in one packet or say a black polythene, and we just throw it outside, let people take it. Well, let the waste management people take it. But it has the glasses also, you have dry waste also, you have wet waste also. So whatever waste you are producing, it goes ultimately to some land, water or air, and it is creating a pollution. So what you have to do, dry waste and wet waste, you have to first of all differentiate. And there are three R's: reduce, reuse and recycle. This is the management, this is the waste management. This is not for the Nagar Nigam or the waste management authority. This is for you. You have to do it. Coming to land management. Land management. Land we use for various purpose. For living, for working, for agriculture, for making homes, for roads, for forest, factories, everything. So the land is limited. The earth, say, you know, circumference and periphery, it's all limited. So use it very, very judiciously. It shows that every people get that their requirement or their requirements are met. And also, the environment should not be damaged. One person living in 100 acres and in one acre, 100 people are living. This should not be there. So what we are trying to say here is that green economy is all about using less resources to cause less pollution and for everyone's growth, everyone. Skill development for green economy. Now, just tell me, if something happens in your house, say microwave is not working, or say your bike or car is not working, what will you do? You will go to a person who knows it. You'll go to a mechanic or an engineer, or you may call him to your house. But the problem is that for green economy or for everything, when we are talking about green economy, we need people who are skilled in green economy or green kind of work. For example, solar cooker, who knows it, how to work, how to maintain it, how to install it. So the key challenge for the any developing country or underdeveloped country is to provide food, energy, water and all the essential goods and services which is required for the growing population. Everyone needs, every country needs it. So we need to alleviate, that is the stop the poverty, reduce the poverty. But in doing that, we have to see that we also talk about sustainable development. That is how, you see, we are saying that we are doing all the strategies which are unsustainable. So we have to move toward or transit toward or slowly go towards the sustainable kind of green economy. That is, it has to be a very smooth and swift kind of transition. It has to be good for everyone and we cannot just do it overnight. So this green job is a concept or is a job. It can be in business, non-profit organization, government and education. So green job has certain requirement. I will talk about certain jobs. For example, agriculture, organic farming. Now a person who is doing farming for years now, he knows the conventional method, traditional method. He's not knowing the organic stuff or new methods like the green economy, etc. So you need to made him skilled, you have to educate him, you need to tell him how to do it. So you need to give him skill development, then the farmer will be able to do it. So this is a green job. It has certain requirement. You see here is a man, and he is actually a green technician or an engineer, or to be precise, he is a solar technician or an engineer. Now this guy is having all the knowledge, all the skill, he has been taught, he has been prepared for it. Now he can design, he can install, and he can maintain the solar panels. So we need skill development for the greener economy also. We just can't ask about green economy. Now, what are green skills? Green skills. See, it's not green colored skills. Skills are basically the way you get a job, you do a job, and you are successful at a job, and you earn money, you earn livelihood. So green skills, the skills used for promoting green economy, these are known as green skills. The skills, as I talked about, renewable energy, sewer water treatment, the cities which are climate, we want you to be making like climate resilient cities. The construction which has to be green construction. Okay, climate resilient, I talked about, that is if the climate change, what you have to do. Construction should be economically unimpacted, or it is not impacting the environment in detrimental way. Solid waste management. So these are not the words, these are basically technologies, these are science. A person has to get the knowledge of this, to do it. So the Green Skill Agreement, what is that? The Green Skill Agreement is the skills for sustainability. Because skills for sustainability, also we call it, we're calling it as green skills. These are the technical skills. These are preparing an individual to do certain work, giving him knowledge, and also providing him or developing the values and attitudes of that workforce, that person who is going to install a solar cooker or install a windmill, knowing that what will be the environmental outcomes of this business, this industry, or how it is useful for the community, how it is bettering the community. So you are basically creating and making the generation who is adopting the green skills and earning the livelihood. So green skills contribute to the sustainable development. How? How do they do it? First is using the renewable energy sources. That is slowly and gradually transferring to the solar power, the wind energy. The waste management, water management is important here. How to do the rainwater harvesting? This also is green skills. A person will be knowing how to do this. How to conserve energy at every day-to-day life work. Reducing the pollution to minimum extent. So green skill is very crucial, very important. Because basically we are transiting. Right now we have economic development and growth. Everyone is a consumer. There is a demand and supply. So we want to go in the aircraft. We want luxurious life. Everyone wants it. So we have an intensive economy. But we need to stop this energy depletion emissions. For that, we need economy to be cleaner, greener production and services. So basically, we are creating people who have green jobs, that is the jobs or the work like a software engineer, like a plumber. Like this, we will have green jobs, and that will preserve and restore the quality of the environment. So a person, we are making him or giving him knowledge, giving him degree like this. For example, a person, a technician. He knows how to have a solar light, how to put a solar cooker, what the solar water heater does. So we require engineers and technicians. Mostly the today's training program, that is the vocational program, they are just focused on, say, a welder. How to make a person a welder. How to make a person technician like a fridge or a microwave, technician. Welder, as I said, for welding. Now, these are most vocational courses doing today. But we need some addition, that is soft or greener skills also to be added. So we have National Skill Development Corporation. And this will be in all different countries only. I'm just talking about one of the country like India. So in 2015, National Skill Development Mission was launched by Government of India in 2015. So the basic idea was to provide all these skill training activities to states, to districts, to the whole country. But we also have to indulge people, the people who are being taught, introducing them to green skills. So green skill is very important for future, and you need to be very vocal about it. People need to know about it, and you need to be very good speaker about it. If you are actually thinking about green jobs, developing green skills. So let me tell you about the Green Consumer Day. This every 20th September every year, we celebrate this Green Consumer Day. So what do? We celebrate our Mother Earth, and we try to make people aware about this by doing very small actions, because we want our globe to be green and clean. So we recycle more in this day. We do certain programs. We also wear color greens, and try to express our feelings toward the Mother Nature, the universe, the planet Earth. See, everything around us is green, either blue or green. Oceans are blue, the sky is blue, but everything is green, and we love green color. Because green, the plants, all the trees, you cannot say that something is happening here in Bangladesh will not affect us, or something happening in, say, Amazon jungles will not affect us. All your global perspective you have to have, not only subjected to your own place or country. Green skills, it is required that you need to be aware, the knowledge. Green skill is important for the future, and also good communication skills are required, because you have to convince, you have to tell, and you have to give your ideas to the people, knowledge. So wherever you go, even if you make a green building, whichever sector, if you are making a green building or involved, then the power and efficiency is the main criteria. So in order to take the whole thing into account, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, they have taken up an initiative to enhance the skill, to develop the skill for skill development in the environment and the forest sector. Because people are running after being a software engineer or, say, a doctor. But today's young or today's youth, there is a program being established or started. So these people can get employment, they can get self-employment, because they are getting skill development from Green Skill Development Program. This is GSDP. GSDP. So main idea of this program is to prepare green skilled worker, those who have knowledge of these green technologies, eco-friendly technologies, and also to develop a commitment for the sustainable development in them. So the environmental change is an important factor, because it is affecting everywhere. Global warming is all over the world. Sometimes in the winter times, or you can say the summertime, the winter time is coming, the snow is coming. So this is affecting the labor demand and skills supply in all the sectors, across all the sectors, like the automotive, like the retails, like the electronics, because you say 5-star or 6-star rating ACs. Then we have power and construction. So everywhere, whichever the sector is responsible for economy, the environmental change and the green skills are required, because green skills are for sustainable development. So these green skills are those skills, they are going to balance economic development and the environmental conservation. That is, we are thinking about the future. We are thinking about the resources, natural resources, and alternative strategies. So, what are the knowledge and skills which are needed for managing resources and supporting the efficiency? For example, there is an individual. Now, you understand him to be a green, having a green skill and going to do a green job. So, we are thinking about a green economy, green growth. So, for example, a green building he is going to make. What are the knowledge and skill is required? Because economy is today in a different way and we have to change it. So, what is the purpose of these green skills and what are the knowledge and skills needed for this green economy? Let us see that. So, first thing is managing the natural resources. So, in order to manage natural resources, what are the skills required? For example, this gentleman, he need to or he has the capability of assessing, auditing and finding the environmental impact, that is the consequence of whatever we are doing. What will be the effect in the future? Then he must know the design and different technologies being adopted that will reduce the consumption of the present natural resources, because those natural resources which are limited, they will die. And see, every India has a constitution, so every industry is run by certain laid down rules. So in order to understand the legislation and the guidelines for sustainable utilization of natural resources, he must have that knowledge. So all these standard operating procedure he must know, because now it is clear, these are laid down, it is not a new thing. Now second thing comes is supporting the climate resilience, that is how the climate is going to change. What are the models? What are the predictions? What is the statistics? What are the graphs? What is going to be? What is today? What it is going to be? Right? So, there is a number, 2. We don't want our global warming or the heat should rise beyond that. And also, he has to take the strategies or risk management strategies he has to develop. Because the resource availability, what is going to be in the future? So one has to take strong decision and risk management strategies also to be adopted. And the resilience means the climate is going to change. And we want this climate to change as little as possible. Because of human consequences, because of what all we are doing, we need resilience. Support resource efficiency, the purpose of this and the knowledge required. That is, all the business models which are being made has to be resource efficient. They are not using the resources heavily. And then to develop and adopt technologies that will maximize the resource utilization. That is, least waste, maximum output. Then the low carbon industry. As I said, the problem is carbon dioxide. If it increases up to certain level, all these snow glaciers will melt and all the low-lying areas will come under water. So, to develop technologies that promote the renewable energy resources or sources like the wind, water and solar, and also to design and adopt technologies and products that will minimize the carbon emissions. So, this is the support to low carbon industry and these are the skills required. What are green jobs? Jobs are just like any job, like you are a software engineer or you are a welder or you are a doctor. So you know about that job, you have learned about that job, and now you are doing the job and you are learning or getting your livelihood, earning your livelihood. Green job is also an employment, and the main idea of this job is to contribute in the industry to preserve or restore the environmental quality in that particular sector. That is, if you want to make a car, you want to make, say, a fridge, you want to make, say, a building. Everywhere, the green job is to ensure that the environmental quality is not impacted and sustainable development is also thought. So, the jobs that help protect ecosystems and the biodiversity and to reduce energy utilization. Ecosystem biodiversity we know, but what about energy and all the materials we are talking about? And main thing is water consumption. All these have to be saved. This is the green job. So a green job can be in any sector. It can be in agriculture. It can be in manufacturing, research, or development activities. It can be anywhere. So the main thing is, we have to transit. We have to go from high carbon production things to low carbon economy. As I said, China is producing 15%. India is producing 7% of the carbon of all over world. So we have to do something to reduce the carbon footprints. If you want to make a building that is a green building, that means it has to be energy efficient and reduce waste. That means to make that building, we need architects, we need engineers, we need technicians, we need plumbers, we need construction workers. All these are green jobs. So these are the fields where green jobs are required. So what are the sectors? What are the areas and field of green economy? And also, what are the green jobs required? For example, agriculture. Now everyone knows about organic farming. We don't need insecticide, pesticide, or any other thing. So we need a water quality technician for that. We need someone who can control this and say about this. How about water management? Watershed management and rainwater harvesting. Basically saving water, whatever is coming in the rain, from the rain. The possibility of saving that water and putting it somewhere so that it can be reused later. So we need green jobs like rainwater harvesting professionals and those technicians who know about this science. We need solar pump technician. We also know how to make a poly house or green house. So poly house professionals and technicians are required. A normal man cannot make it. The next thing comes is in this where green job and green skills are required is construction. So construction. Now today what we are doing? Any energy appliances. So everyone who is doing this planning, design and manufacturing of the lighting appliances or any other equipment, or anyone wants to increase the efficiency, because today a building is there, we cannot just destroy them. We need energy audit and try to find out how to reduce the power usage. Then planning, designing and construction of green buildings. These green buildings, new buildings are being made. How that has to be green buildings. We need a plumber. We need sensor based equipment. We need a green plumbing. So this kind of job is required. So we need people for that. So we need green builders. We need design professionals. We need green workers for that. So all these are skills being required. These are the green jobs. When coming to energy, so wherever we have power plants, so how this power plant is working, first we have to research, construct and monitor how much carbon it is producing. And the main thing is to increase the efficiency, because even 5% or 10% utilization or loss we secure, it is always good. So we need solar cell technicians and engineers. We need professionals who know wind energy, how to exploit it, how to use windmill. So we need wind energy workers. We need biofuel workers. That is all the fuels which are coming from the nature. We can make fuel from them. And wave energy products, where to install turbine in which area so that the waves produces the electricity. Then coming to the forestry. So we need people who know about reforestation, afforestation and agroforestry and vertical farming. That is doing the farming along with the this forestry. So these are basically utilization of natural resources. For these we need again green jobs. Nature scientists, we know we need them. If we talk about retail, so those products being made which are greener products and those are targeted for green stores, they have to be eco-friendly, they have to be environmental friendly. For that we need people who can tell that. Green salespersons, accountants, cashiers, sale associates. For example, you go who is going to tell you about this, the use of solar cooker? Who is going to sell it to you? Coming to automotive and transport industry, because we need clean car engineers, because we are making vehicles now. Whatever vehicles we are making, they have to be clean as far as fuel consumption is concerned. So we need to have an alternative fueled vehicles. Not petrol, diesel is already there, but we just want to shift from there. So we need clean car engineers. These are the green jobs. These are the green skills required. Tourism and hospitality. So here we need eco-friendly practices. Like if people are there, what will be the centralized lighting? How will be the air condition working? How to save the electricity? And along with this, for tourism hospitality, we need people who are eco-tour guides. So we need eco-tour guides and green tour guides. They may tell, they know how to reduce and utilize energy as much as possible. Education. Until unless you give, in order to have a green growth and green economy, we need people who are educated in this science, in this sector. So how to reduce the natural resources? We need teachers who can teach environmental education. Okay, those who can promote green growth and economy. So we need green scientists. We need the conservation biologist. Flora and fauna is known by biologists only. So that is how we have different green jobs which are required. There are certain green projects. There are people who have come up and who have started thinking about environment long back. They are self-motivated and they are doing everything to save the environment, save the earth, save the humankind actually. They want to save the biodiversity, the ecosystem, the flora and fauna, and of course human life. So there are certain green projects. So those projects which are mainly aimed for, say, water waste management, for energy conservation and sanitation, proper sanitation, green sanitation, in order to use biofuel, use making green buildings. So there are certain great projects being taken and they were successful, and we need to know about them, and we should be a part of this, or we can also start some new projects. So these are basically focused for sustainable development. One of these product or project is solid waste management by Swachh Cooperative, and these are totally owned by Kula Uthane Wale, that is waste pickers. This is a cooperative, and these are members who are basically going to doorstep and collecting the waste. So we are taking the informal waste pickers, basically integrating these into there is a city called Pune in India. So solid waste management is taking place here, and this is really a success, because the government there also, they are supporting it, these waste pickers. So now these waste pickers are not well respected, but now they are given dignity, they are well respected, and now they have created a decentralized waste management system. This is ensuring the proper disposal of the, as I said, dignity is there and waste management system has been established. Now the disposable of wet waste, how they can create the biogas of this waste, how can they can recycle the solid waste. So they already have a biogas, they are producing it through the animal waste and garbage, household waste which is coming, and also the industrial waste also they are collecting, like fish processing, dairies and sewage treatment plant. They are also producing a lot of waste. So basically it's a mixture of gases like methane, carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide and water vapor. And since in this mixture, methane burns easily, so it's a kind of fuel. So they are producing biogas also. That is why this kind of project is always required. And we really salute these kind of people who have initiated, and they are so motivated, they are working on it. And those people who are, say, marginalized, they are being respected now. See here, everyone is respected now. Modern Chula of Society Development and Environment Protection. So previously, it is about a chulha or the stove used in the traditional times in India. So now we have created, or this project has created, those energy efficient cooking stoves, they were called as chulhas. And now the movement of air is okay here, because the wood being burned, the person who is making food, he is going to have 1000 cigarettes, the ashes, dhua. So the modern DEEP, this is Development and Environment Protection. So this is a chulha. So modern deep chulha, it was created by Society of Development and Environment Protection. This chulha is using biomass. Biomass means all the product which is by itself given by our nature. So now the consumption of the wood has decreased to 50%. This chulha reduces smoke by 80%. And this is reducing the environment also and the health problems also. So here this project is aiming to train these masons and the welders so that they can produce these stoves or chulhas. So now the environmental environment is also seen, employment is also increasing, and the entrepreneurship opportunities are also there. So this is a kind of project which was actually initiated by 35,000 households in Solan district in Himachal Pradesh in 1995. You see, people have started thinking about that long back. Biotoilet by Green Solution Foundation, GSF. So this GSF, they have created a biotoilet. And what is this solution? This is for a hygienic sanitation in village and slums, in cities, where the sewage system is not there. So the donors or the users, they have thought that there is no sewage system. So now this foundation is making bio toilets. And here they are also giving toilets on how to make this toilet. And they are also giving the service to the local population. So now the employment is also created in the local population and the entrepreneurship opportunities are always there. So biodigester tank, this is the basis of this eco-friendly toilet, because basically aerobic bacteria is being used and that converts the human excreta or waste into environment standard compatible water, and this water can be used for flushing or even for the irrigation. So the reuse, recycle and reduce is being used here. So the green benefits is this: water is conserved. This is a sewage system, wonderful, efficient sewage system. And what all contamination is being done is decreased. And this also, because, you know, if the unhygienic situation always create the disease. So we have a hygienic situation, sanitation here. Coming to question and answer, which of the following options describes a green economy correctly? Since this is an option, so we can choose more of them. One of them I'm showed here. I'll tell you the other one also. A green economy means what? It uses less resources. Absolutely true. Uses more resources. No, wrong. Waste less items. So this is also true. Waste more items. No, this is wrong. So since they are asking about the options, multiple options, so you can choose A and C together. So this A and C is the answer. So you will take A also and C also. More than one options you can choose. Short answer. Since we have discussed it all in the chapter, I'll just give you a hint. What are green skills? So these green skills are those skills required to adapt processes, services and products to climate change and the environment rules and necessities related to it. Basically, we are talking about the sustainable development. So green skill is all about saving the biodiversity, saving the you know, planet Earth. So product, services, whichever you are talking about. Because we are talking about climate change. We want the environment to stay there the way it is. And we want it for our kids also. So they embrace the information, abilities, values and attitudes required to live in, develop and support a sustainable and resource-friendly, efficient society. Okay. So we need all society should come and talk about resource efficient society. So these skills are needed in various areas: renewable energy, sewer water treatment, climate resilient cities, green construction, solid waste management. So these are all where green skills, green jobs, green information is required. Okay. These are the green skills. You can give the idea about what we have learned also. Give two examples of green skills that you can start learning from now. So now you can add. I'm just giving you an example. Using of solar energy, using of wind energy, using of biomass, producing biofuel, producing the this biogas. Use of hydroelectricity, it's quite difficult because you have to make a dam or put a turbine, and it's kind of a whole process. But what you see is biomass, biogas you can produce at your backyard. You can use the solar energy, solar cell, solar power. Even you can use wind also.